Genesis begins it all, and appropriately it's at the beginning of the Bible. Genesis really means beginning. If it were anywhere else in the Bible, that would be kind of confusing. Can you make a light without a light switch, or water without a spigot? Can you make a man from a dustpan? Well, you can't but guess what God did it. Let there be light, there it was. Plus bugs and rhinoceroses. Adam and Eve had one rule to follow, but they ate from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, causing trouble for all subsequent people. In Genesis begins it all, and appropriately it's at the beginning of the Bible. Genesis really means beginning. If it were anywhere else in the Bible, that would be kind of confusing. Can you make a man build a zoo? Oh, and make it so the whole thing flows. Well, God told Noah to build a big boat, and I'm sure you're aware of old Abraham and Sarah, Isaac and Rebecca, Jacob, Rachel, and their 12 sons. There's a ton more in there that we would really like to share, but we just can't make it clear in this song here. About Genesis begins it all, and appropriately it's at the beginning of the Bible. Genesis really means beginning. If it were anywhere else in the Bible, that would be kind of confusing. That would be kind of confusing.
In the Bible.
That would be kind of confusing.
In the Bible.
I took a bus from Texas just to sing a song about Exodus, the story of the Israelites enslaved. Until a man named Moses, who did just what God had told him to, and Jacob's sons and daughters all were saved. Oh, Texas bus, take me on an exodus, way beyond this mess and fuss. Take me to the promised land, and we'll discuss what we learned in Exodus about the burning bush and the one who saved his children from the grip of Pharaoh's hand. I took a bus from Texas just to sing a song about Exodus. Now it's done, it's time to head back home.
A bunch of rules too. When they had questions or needed direction, they took a little look at the rule book section. What's delicious or mischievous? It's all right there in the book of Leviticus, a reference guide for the Israelite life. If you don't get it at first, then read it twice. Could they eat? What did they do if they grew some sort of skin disease? Ooh, a slew of rules just for the priest. God said, here's what you do to worship me. Remember what you heard from us when you think you might skip Leviticus. I like my PB&J without any crust, but that's not addressed in Leviticus.
Third book in the Bible.
I always picture him with a beard.
I picture him with a mustache, though I know that's a little weird.
There was a time when he gathered all the Israelites around. He told them some things and said, I should probably write this down. That's now the book of Deuteronomy. 40 days worth of sermons in 1410 BC. Moses reminded everybody who'd been wandering around in the wilderness. God gives you his best, give him your best, and you will be blessed. Everyone brought out their lawn chairs, just like a nice day at the beach.
But it wasn't a beach, it was a smoking hot desert, and Moses was giving a speech.
Gee, that doesn't seem too exciting to me.
I mean, does it to you?
Well, a mustache man who speaks directly to God is probably worth listening to.
That's now the book of Deuteronomy. The famous last words of Moses given at the age of 120. That's when he reminded everyone before they went into the land of promise. God gives you his best, give him your best, and you will be blessed. That's now the book of Deuteronomy. It's been translated into English for you and me. And that's a good thing because it was originally written in Hebrew. I don't know Hebrew, but if you do, I'd like to meet you. I don't know Hebrew, but if you do, I'd like to meet you.
Adam and Eve and Joseph and
sometimes called five books of Moses
is the one whose life composes
the storyline of all these books with the exception of Genesis. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers.
Read a little every day before you slumber.
Cap it all off with a trip through Deuteronomy.
Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy.
Parts are fun, others not so much.
Rifts in and flooding and plagues and such.
Whether you're German or French or Dutch,
we can all learn a thing from the Pentateuch.
That's not right. Whether you're a king or a queen or a duke,
we can all learn a thing from the Pentateuch.
Genesis is the introduction.
Tells why the world has ceased to function.
Quite the way God intended it from the start.
From the start, from the very beginning.
Sin came in and made a mess of
all the ways God was gonna bless us.
Because we did not trust him with all our hearts.
And now we've fallen, the world is fallen. Oh yes, we've fallen away from God.
It's a tragedy, nasty tragedy.
And now we're broken, our hearts are broken. And now the world is seriously flawed.
It's all messed up!
But God's gonna launch his rescue plan.
It starts with Sarah and Abraham.
And the big, big promise for Jacob and all his kids. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 12.
Then in Egypt, they get stuck.
Slaves to Pharaoh, out of luck.
Till God told Moses he'd help out.
And that's what he did.
You bet your bippy.
We see in Exodus they have success because Moses respects our God and his decree.
That's a fancy word for law.
And now it's Sinai. The laws get piled up high.
God asked if they will try.
And they agree.
Leviticus is a bunch of rules.
The numbers, the Israelites act like fools.
40 years later, Moses schooled them again.
Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy.
We'll try harder, the young one said.
Moses gets older, now he's dead.
Follow Joshua instead, all the way to the promised land.
We like the Bible, it's not a fluke. That it all starts out with the Pentateuch.
Adam and Joseph and
whether you're a king or a queen or a duke,
we can all learn a thing from the Pentateuch.
Before we get to Matthew, Mark, and Luke,
we really need to understand the Pentateuch.